Hello students, welcome back. Today we are going to discuss another problem of physics from class 9 NCERT. The question reads as, a ball is dropped from a 100 meter high tower and at the same time another ball is thrown up vertically from the bottom of the tower with a speed of 25 meter per second. Find the position and time where they cross each other. So this is a common question often asked by children. When they solve the NCERT questions, this is given in chapter Gravitation of NCERT. The question, according to the question, the situation is something like this, that there is a 100 meter high tower and from the 100 meter high tower, there is a ball which is thrown, which is dropped down. Dropping means that you are not giving any initial velocity to the ball, you are just letting it go. So this is having, suppose this is our ball 1. And ball 1 has initial velocity 0. I am labeling it as U1 to indicate that this is the first ball. Now, the second ball is thrown up. According to the question, ball 2 is thrown up vertically with some initial velocity of 25 meter per second. The question is asking us that in this situation, they will be particularly crossing at a point. The question is asking that at what point will they cross each other? At what point do they cross each other? So there are two ways of doing this question. One is using vector notations and one is using the scalar equations. In class 9, usually we are not explaining the children of the concept of equations in vector form. But still I'll try to explain it with both the ways. I am first doing it with the scalar method. This is the condition given for ball 1 and ball 2. When the ball 1 is coming down, it is accelerated due to gravity. So it means that its acceleration could be written as 10 meter per second square. I am writing it as A1. The ball is being pulled down because of gravity. So its speed is increasing constantly at a rate of 10 meter per second square. But coming to ball 2, for ball 2, the gravity is acting in a direction opposite to its motion. The ball is moving up, gravity is pulling it down. So acceleration due to gravity in this case will be taken as minus 10 meter per second square. Remember children, I am doing it with a scalar method. So now I may write down the data for ball 1 and for ball 2. For ball 1, I have taken initial velocity u1 as 0, which is given in the question that it is dropped with some, it is dropped from that height. Then acceleration A1 is 10 meter per second square. You can take it 9.8 also, but 10 is just for the ease of numericals that we take this value. Then suppose they are meeting at this point. If they are meeting at this point, we can assume that this distance is some x value from the top maybe, or maybe from the bottom. So I am taking this value, the point at which they are meeting, as some value x. Suppose these two balls are meeting at some value x from the top. So this remaining distance from the bottom will be equal to 100 minus x, because the whole height of the tower is 100 meters. So using this assumption also, I can write that displacement of the ball 1 is x meters. In the direction of in the downward direction, and then moving to ball 2, the initial velocity of ball 2 is 25 meter per second. Acceleration of the second ball is minus 10 meter per second square, and the displacement, I should write it S2 and S1 here. S2 is 100 minus x, because we are considering about the time and the position where they are crossing each other. Let the time of meeting be, let the time at which they cross, each other is t time pe wo dono cross kar jate hain. So when they cross each other, at that time S1 and S2 will be equal to each other. So let us first write down the equation for S1. S1 will be equal to x that we have assumed, and that will be equal to u1t plus half a1t square using the second equation of motion. Substituting the values, I get half into 10 t square, which is equal to 5 t square. X is equal to 5 t square. This is what I get for the first ball. Then second ball ke liye, we have S2 is equal to 100 minus X, which is equal to U2T plus half A2T square. I am taking the time common for both because they are crossing at that time. So U2 will be taken as 25, T is the same, plus half. Now since A2 has a negative value, so I write it minus 5T square here because half of 10 will be 5. So this is 100 minus X on this side. So we get two relations, S1 and S2 for both the balls. Now since X can be substituted as 5t square in this equation, or we can replace 5t square with X. So I am dealing with this equation now. I can write 100 minus X is equal to 25t. 100 minus X is equal to 25t minus X, which cancels off from both the sides, and I get the value of t as 4 seconds. Then using this value of t, I also get X is equal to, you have X as 5t square, so this will be 5 multiplied by 16, which is equal to 80 meter. So what does it mean? That these two balls are crossing at a point which is 80 meters from the top. And it also means that this point is 20 meters from the bottom. Now let us check out this question. The same question with vector method with proper sign conventions. So let us look at the sign conventions way. This is ball 1 which is dropped down. This is ball 1 with initial velocity 0, u1 is 0. And suppose this is ball 2 which is thrown up. Ball 2 thrown up with some initial velocity of 25 meter per second. Now in vector symbols, vector notations, what do we take as the signs that we assume? If this is the coordinate axis, then all the distances towards right are taken as positive. All the distances towards left are taken as negative. All the distances above the origin are taken to be positive. And all the values below the origin are taken negative. This is the Cartesian coordinate system that we follow. Applying the same concept of Cartesian coordinate system, here in our case, we can assume all the distances, all the vectors in downward direction, all the vectors that are pointing in downward directions will be taken to be negative. All the vectors pointing in upward direction will be taken as positive. So here, acceleration due to gravity, which is acting in both the cases, will be taken with a negative sign when we are talking about vectors. Ball is coming down, so downward motion mein aapka displacement aur initial velocity ye sab cheeze negative jayengi. Ball 2 ke liye displacement bhi positive hoga aur uska initial velocity bhi positive hoga. To inko hum kaise use karte hain, let us look at that thing. Hamara suppose I consider the ground to be the origin. Ye hamara ground jo hai, this is point 0. This is 0 point. And in the question it is given that this point is some 100 meters. Ye 100 meter hai. To jab ball 1 niche aa rahi hai, to ball 1 ka initial position ball 1 ka hai 100 meters. Aur fir uske baad mein ball ka jo displacement hai wo dheere dheere niche ki taraf aa raha hai. To aap iske displacement ke liye, for the first ball 1 ka jo displacement hai, agar main usko S1 likhna chahun, to S1 will be 100 meters, which is already there. हमारा जो initial position है 100 meters वो पहले से है, plus u1t plus half a1t square. ये equation हमारी first ball के लिए displacement की बनेगी. Now let us substitute the values which are given in the question itself. 100 meters remain as it is. U1 is 0 for the first ball. And A1 की जगह पे हम यहाँ पे minus t लगाएंगे because gravity is acting in downward direction. So it will be minus half into 10 t square. So this becomes 100 minus 5 t square. This is the value of displacement of the first ball. Likewise, for the second ball, इफ आई राइट डिस्प्लेसमेंट एज एस टू, अब ये जो एस टू है इट्स जर्नी इज बिगनिंग फ्रॉम ओरिजिन इटसेल्फ, ओरिजिन से ये शुरू कर रहा है, तो ओरिजिन से शुरू करके ऊपर की तरफ जा रहा है और ऊपर वाला डायरेक्शन तो पॉजिटिव ही है. तो फॉर द बॉल टू एस टू विल बी इक्वल टू इनिशियल पोजिशन इज जीरो, सो आई डोंट हैव टू राइट दिस टर्म हियर. इट विल बी सिंपली यू टू टी प्लस हाफ ए टू टी स्क्वायर. एक्सेलरेशन इन बोथ द केसेज विल बी टेकन विद अ नेगेटिव साइन बिकॉज इन वेक्टर साइन कन्वेंशन वी डोंट टेक एक्सेलरेशन टू बी एक्सेलरेटिंग और रिटार्डिंग इन डिफरेंट केसेज. हम यहाँ पे फिर से कोई लगाएंगे तो बिकॉज यू टू इज इन पॉजिटिव डायरेक्शन इट विल बी टेकन विद अ प्लस साइन 25t प्लस हाफ, अगेन द एक्सेलरेशन इज नेगेटिव सो आई राइट माइनस हाफ मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 10t स्क्वायर. दिस इज द इक्वेशन फॉर एस टू विच गिव्स मी 25t माइनस 5t स्क्वायर. नाउ व्हेन दीज टू बॉल्स दे क्रॉस ईच अदर, जब ये दोनों एक दूसरे को क्रॉस करती हैं तो उस पॉइंट पे S1 और S2 बराबर हो जाएगा, यानी इसकी पोजिशन और बॉल टू की पोजिशन दोनों बराबर हो जाएंगी. तो when they cross each other S1 and S2 become equal to each other. When we equate these two equations we get 100 minus 5t square is equal to 25t minus 5t square. दोनों क्रॉस कर रही है तो अभी आप दोनों साइड से 5t square could be cancelled and you get the value of t as 100 by 25 which is 4 seconds again. 4 seconds is the time when both the balls they cross each other. Now substituting the value of t in any of the equation we can get the position. So if I put it here S1 mein dalti hu agar to S1 mein I get 100 minus 5 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 4 which is 80. Here the product is 80, 100 mein se minus kiya to S1 becomes equal to 20 meters and S2 becomes equal to 25 multiplied by 4 minus 5t square. So this is also equal to 20 meter. So what was S1? S1 was the displacement of ball 1 when taken from the origin. So origin se ye jo ball S1 hai ye 20 meters par hai. And similarly बॉल टू इज ऑल्सो टेकन फ्रॉम द ओरिजिन सो इट मीन्स दैट एस टू इज ऑल्सो 20 मीटर्स. इसका मतलब दोनों बॉल्स जो है वो ओरिजिन से 20 मीटर्स के डिस्टेंस पर है. इट मीन्स दैट बोथ द बॉल्स आर मीटिंग एट अ पॉइंट विच इज 20 मीटर्स अबव द ओरिजिन. लेट्स टेक अनदर एग्जाम्पल. अ बुलेट ऑफ 10 ग्राम स्ट्राइक्स अ सैंड बैग एट अ स्पीड ऑफ 10^3 मीटर पर सेकेंड एंड गेट्स एम्बेडेड after traveling 5 cm. Calculate the resistive force exerted by the sand on the bullet. And the second part is asking us to find out the time taken by the bullet to come to rest. So in this question, we see that the resistive force means the retarding force which is offered by the sandbag. The values which are given to us are mass of the bullet is 10 gram. In SI system, this will be equal to 10 upon 1000. Better way to write it is as 10^-2 kg. This is the mass of bullet. Initial velocity of the bullet is 10^3 meter per second. And when it comes to rest, the final velocity becomes 0. The question is also giving us information that it travels certain distance of 5 centimeters, which is equal to 5 multiplied by 10^-2 meters before it comes to rest. So using the values of u, v and s we can easily find out the value of acceleration in the according to the third equation of motion which says 2as is equal to v square minus u square, which means a will be equal to v square minus u square upon 2s. Now let us start putting the values here. V square, final velocity squared is 0 in this case. U square means initial velocity squared. Initial velocity is 10^3. The square of this value will be 10^6 upon 2 multiplied by s. S is 5 multiplied by 10^-2. Solving this all, we get acceleration is equal to minus 10 raised to the power 6 upon, this is again 10, 10 multiplied by 10 raised to the power minus 2 will be 10 raised to the power minus 1. 10 raised to the power minus 1 taken to the numerator will be 10 raised to the power 1. This gives us 10 raised to the power 7 meter per second square. So this is the value of acceleration. Now we have to find out the resistive force. So force is the product of mass and acceleration. Mass of the bullet is 10 raised to the power minus 2 kg. And acceleration we have just found, it is 10 raised to the power 7 meter per second square. When we solve this, we get 10 raised to the power 5 kg meter per second square. And this is also known as Newton. The unit kg meter per second square is Newton. So we have found the first part of the question, resistive force exerted by the sand on the bullet. Now we are left to find out the time taken by the bullet to come to rest. Time also we can find out by any ways. The easiest way, which I think here, is t is equal to v minus u upon a. This is the value that we, this is the relation that we get from the first equation only. V in the question is 0, u in the question is 10 raised to the power 3, and a is 10 raised to the power minus 10 raised to the power 7. When you solve this, you get 10 raised to the power 3 minus 7, which is equal to 10 raised to the power minus 4 seconds. You see that time is coming with a positive sign and acceleration is coming with a negative sign. Acceleration is negative here because it is retarding the body. Force is also, the value is this one, but it should be with a negative sign, mentioned with a negative sign. The value of force is negative, but when we state the value only, jab hum sirf value bolte hain, to 10 raised to the power 5 hoga, aur jab hum uska pura magnitude aur direction ke saath mein bolte hain, this negative sign here is indicating that the force is acting in a direction opposite to the motion of bullet. That is why this minus sign is appearing here. But the value of force will be 10 to the power 5 Newton. So this is how we can solve this one. Now let's see another example. The question says, a truck of mass M is moved under force F. If the truck is loaded with an object equal to the mass of truck and the driving force is reduced to half, find the percentage change in its acceleration. It means that in the first case, let mass of the truck is equal to M, we don't know the mass. Acceleration of the truck is equal to some value A, and force acting on the truck, if we assume it to be F, then according to the question, the force value is already mentioned in the question, that we have to take this variable as F. So according to the question, force must be equal to M into A. This is for the first condition, where you are taking mass of the truck as M. Now, when you double the mass, you are adding some mass to it. So in the second case, what is happening? Mass of the truck becomes double its mass. Mass of the truck becomes M dash, which is equal to 2M. The new mass I am taking as M prime or M dash, which is 2M. Acceleration of the truck we don't know. Acceleration we have to find. Let us assume that this acceleration is A dash. We don't know about it. And the question says that force on the truck has been reduced to half. Yani pehle jitna force lag raha tha F, abhi uska aadha lag raha hai F by 2. We can use the Newton's second law relation directly here. According to that, the new force, if I write it as F dash, the naya force must be equal to M dash multiplied by A dash. Now F dash, according to the question, is F by 2, M dash is 2M, and A dash is unknown. So I may write it as A dash is equal to F upon 4M. And here where we had F is equal to MA, yahan pe hum likh sakte hain A is equal to F upon M. So suppose this is equation number 1, this is equation number 2. Equation number 1 jo hume batata hai ki A F by M ke barabar hai, और इक्वेशन नंबर टू हमें बताता है कि ए डैश जो है वो एफ बाय फोर एम के बराबर है। तो अगर मैं सिर्फ इतने से पार्ट को देखूं, एफ बाय एम को अगर देखूं, तो एफ बाय एम इज नथिंग बट ए, तो आई कैन ऑल्सो राइट ए डैश एज ए बाय फोर। एफ बाय एम की जगह हम ए लिख सकते हैं। तो वॉट डज इट मीन? इट मीन्स दैट द न्यू एक्सेलरेशन इज वन फोर्थ ऑफ द ओरिजिनल एक्सेलरेशन। द क्वेश्चन इज आस्किंग अस टू फाइंड द परसेंटेज चेंज इन द एक्सेलरेशन। परसेंटेज चेंज का मतलब होता है चेंज अपॉन ओरिजिनल मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 100, चेंज अपॉन ओरिजिनल मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 100। सो लेट अस सी व्हाट दिस गिव्स अस। चेंज इन एक्सेलरेशन, चेंज इन एक्सेलरेशन का मतलब होगा नया एक्सेलरेशन माइनस पुराना एक्सेलरेशन। तो नया एक्सेलरेशन जो है इट इज इक्वल टू ए बाय फोर, देन ओल्ड एक्सेलरेशन इज ए एंड न्यू एक्सेलरेशन इज ए बाय फोर। टेकिंग द डिफरेंस ऑफ दीज टू वी गेट माइनस थ्री बाय फोर ए। डेल्टा साइन रिप्रेजेंट्स द चेंज, चेंज इन एक्सेलरेशन इज माइनस थ्री बाय फोर अपॉन ए। सो इफ आई शिफ्ट ए ऑन दिस साइड आई गेट माइनस डेल्टा ए बाय ए एज माइनस थ्री बाय फोर, एंड इफ आई मल्टीप्लाई बोथ द साइड विद 100 आई गेट द परसेंटेज चेंज एज वेल, बिकॉज आई टोल्ड यू दैट परसेंटेज चेंज इज चेंज अपॉन ओरिजिनल मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 100। तो इफ आई मल्टीप्लाई दिस साइड ऑल्सो विद 100 आई गेट द परसेंटेज चेंज, दिस इज इक्वल टू माइनस 75%। वॉट इज माइनस साइन इंडिकेटिंग हियर? इट इज शोइंग दैट द एक्सेलरेशन इज रिड्यूसिंग by how much? It is reducing by 75%. This is what we get information in this question.